site, particularly, that's a word. You know, I do words professionally. That's what I'm doing up here. Particularly excited to chat to our next guest. You might know him from Love, Simon, or you might know him as Wally West, Kid Flash. He is Keenan Lonsdale. Got to find Please welcome into the stage, everyone. Woo. Everyone does this jump up onto the stage.
It's
what's
so inviting.
The deal?
I don't know. It's like we could go swivel over here or we could fly up. It's like.
And what option are you going to take when you can walk up the stairs or fly?
You can fly. Yeah. Most people choose fly.
All right.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
So you've been on the Oz Comic Con tour the last couple of weeks. How does it feel to be here?
Oh, it feels really good. It's so nice to be home. Yeah, it's really good. Everyone's so lovely. Everyone's so sweet.
What do you miss most about home while you're away?
Outside of like family, friends, I guess it's just like an ease in conversation.
Yeah.
That familiar energy is always really nice. Yeah. Tim Tams.
Now, I don't know if you heard the last panel, but Aisha invented Tim Tam straws. Because you know how we do the Tim Tam Slam?
Tim Tam Slam.
She's like, why don't you just make them into actual straws?
Wow.
So we're going to chat to some scientists and we're going to make this happen.
Right. You no need for plastic.
No.
Just Tim Tam straws.
So you keen to come on board?
Yes.
Excellent.
Will I make lots of money?
No.
Okay.
Probably not.
Well, I
probably
have
not.
Lots of chocolate.
We'll have lots of chocolate and fun and friends.
That's okay.
Tell me a bit about Rainbow Dragon. How did it come about? What's the reception to it been like?
Oh, yeah. It's been amazing. So I released, Rainbow Dragon is my first single from my first album that will come, hopefully at the beginning of next year. And it was just this kind of wild ride to try and make it happen. The music video is an expression of all these different characters and personas that I had sort of living inside of my head. And I think in a way to help me feel less overwhelmed and, in my head, I had to get them out. And so to be able to have them become these sort of like tangible characters in art form was like really important to me. And it was really therapeutic to separate that from myself and be like, oh, okay, I can be Keenan, and then I can get to express through all these other characters through that. And so that's what the music video is, along with some, I guess, messages to cut through to people and to myself about how we treat each other and the world.
Yeah, and it seems like those messages are really resonating with people too.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, from the feedback and stuff, like people seem to be feeling it, so
nice.
Couldn't ask for more.
So do you have a solid idea about what kind of performer do you want to be, like what you want to be putting forward to an audience?
No, I actually don't. I go through periods where I have such clarity and I really have a vision of what I want, but then sometimes the vision disappears, so I have to wait for more puzzle pieces to come in. And so I've learned that I need to be patient before the full picture is complete, and then I guess I'll be on stage and I'll go, oh, this is the performer that I am. I figured it out with the music and the videos, and the next stage is live performance.
So take me back to your first day on set as Kid Flash. What was going through your mind?
A lot of things. Honestly, because I was a fan of the show season one, and then all of a sudden, I'm on the show. Can you imagine what that feels like? It's really overwhelming. And the whole cast is there, and they're just like, oh, Key, we're so excited to have you here. And they were just hugging me, and I was like, yeah, it's nice to meet everyone. I was super quiet. and just sort of ready to get into it. But it felt like a real introduction, especially the way that Wally was brought in and sort of just sort of getting to like knock on that door and start that journey. It was, was very cool.
And how has your life changed since you knocked on that door?
In countless ways. To be able to interact with people and to meet kids that give you a certain kind of look, and you know, that I remember giving to other people is like very, very it's pretty crazy. It's awesome to know that something that you're part of inspires people. It is a dream come true to get to play a superhero. And then just learning a lot of life lessons and as an actor, as a person. I think when you're shooting any TV show and that many episodes per season, you're bound to learn quite a lot. And it also feels like quite good training. Yeah. So a lot's changed.
Yeah. Why do you think heroes are important?
I think it's important to be able to see what's possible. And although, like, you know, in the superhero world and in the sci-fi world, you know, there's things that perhaps go beyond reality. I can run that fast. It sparks something that feels really close to home, I think, for a lot of people. And that's why they feel so relatable. And they are still human stories. So I think it teaches us the kind of people that we want to be. It shows us like the challenges that people can go through, and we get to connect that to our own lives. And it gives us hope. It certainly gives me that hope and some fuel to be like, all right, I just saw them take on like this alien, or they just saved the entire world. I can go to work. I can do this. I can like say this to that person, and I don't have to be so afraid. Like, it helps. It helps you sort of march forward. I think heroes are important, just as examples of what we are all capable of.
Yeah, excellent. So, how hard is it to get into the suit?
It is difficult. It's like a 5 to 10 minute. Process, because well, with mine there's zippers but no kind of little zipper attachment, I forget what it's called. Yep. So they need to get like a little tool for two people to basically like zip you up in it and get you out of it. You can't do it yourself, so I guess it is kind of tricky. And the cowl as well, you can't get it on or off by yourself either. So,
have you ever needed to get out of the suit in a hurry and everyone's just like scrambling to undress you?
Yes. Yeah, definitely. Especially when, but you know, the crew is so quick and so onto it. Yeah. And I think by the time that I had joined, you know, they had already worked with Grant for quite some time. They learned some of the things and sort of the way that they wanted it to be structured. So we had it pretty good.
Nice.
Yeah.
Now, I'm about to head into a round of rapid-fire questions here. Mm. This is the time when you all in the audience can raise your hands and we're going to have some volunteers come over to you and shine little lights around so that we know where you are and can answer your questions. But first, are you ready?
Yes.
What talent do you wish you had?
Juggling.
I'm not even going to make you elaborate on that. That's great. Mm. What's your skincare routine? Oh,
damage control. I use like tea tree oil and after I cleanse and then moisturize after that. But I'm trying to figure out, I got to switch it up. You know, it changes every couple years. Sometimes things work for a period of time and then my skin changes. So right now I'm trying to switch it up.
There you go. Where's your favorite place in the whole world?
Oh, I don't know. Just whenever I feel at home. Yeah, and that could be really anywhere. And suddenly then it's my favorite place in the world, you know?
Yeah.
Which is cool.
What's a movie you've watched over and over and over again and will just keep watching over and over and over again? Mm.
Gosh. I couldn't say right now. No, I'm drawing a complete blank. But I will say that when Love, Simon came out, I watched it like 6 times in the theaters. all my friends wanted to go. It was such a moment. So we just kept watching it, and having the audience, getting to see the audience react was really cool. Yeah. Yeah, I can't answer.
Are you comfortable watching yourself? You're one of those people that is.
I guess I was at
it?
That time. I watched it 6 times. So. Yeah. but I haven't watched something I've been in for a long time. Probably since then. Probably overdid it.
Interesting.
It depends. I think it's like you work on something. I like to edit, so I really like editing. And then once it's done, it's pretty difficult for me to watch it again.
What are you reading right now?
Like 5 books at once, which is not a good idea. There's a book called Children of Blood and Bone I'm reading. Also like a Barack Obama biography.
Goals.
Yeah. A book by a guru, I guess, called like Osho. On love and and then another book called that escalated quickly about like an accidental activist. So
nice.
A few. I should focus on one at a time.
Maybe get one finished. That'd be good.
Yeah.
And final question before we go to the audience. Are you a morning person or a night owl?
Lately, I've been more of a morning person, but at times I'll be a night owl. I guess if I'm writing and recording, usually if I'm by myself, and I can do that at night, through the night. But this year, I've been trying to wake up like around 6 or 7 and get into things, start my routine.
So it's kind of one of those things, depends on what kind of creative pursuit you're doing as to what time of day works for you.
Uh-huh.
That's cool.
Yep. What about you?
Nice. I'm a morning person.
Yeah.
I'm like awake at 5:30.
Wow.
Yeah. Before everyone else wakes up, I can get stuff done.
That's nice.
It's nice. It's nice.
That's cool.
Would you all like to join in on this chat as well? Where's our first question? Over here. Okay.
What's your favorite line and scene from The Flash?
My favorite line and scene from The Flash? I don't have all the Savitar scenes were pretty extreme. they were pretty emotional. But I like to say, like, Flashpoint was my favorite episode because it was the first time I got to, you know, rock the suit and sort of become Kid Flash. It was such a really overwhelming moment. I would say that.
Next question. It's over here.
Who's your favorite Flash character?
These questions are tricky. I'm going to say my favorite character. It switches. Depends on the day. Let's go with Cisco. But it depends what mood you're in, right? Maybe the next day it's Reverse Flash. Maybe you're feeling a little angry and your favorite is Reverse Flash. Yeah.
Next question over here.
So I got a bit of a tough one. Do you like pineapple on pizza?
I do. That's not a tough question for me. I might lose some fans. But be yourself, you know?
If you like pineapple on a pizza, you have pineapple on a
own
pizza.
Own it. Yeah, be proud. Don't let them take you down.
Would you eat just a pineapple pizza, though? Like nothing else on it?
So a pineapple?
Just pineapple.
Oh, never.
Yeah.
See,
there's a line. There's always a line. Next question is over here.
Oh. Hey, Flash.
How good do you fight?
How good are you at fighting?
How good are you at fighting?
How good are you at fighting?
Oh, not nearly as good as you. but I'm close, you know. I like to say I'm a lover, not a fighter. but yeah, if I'm fighting for something I believe in, then I'm pretty great. Thanks.
It's different kinds of fighting.
Yeah, fighting for love.
Up here.
Marvel or DC?
Do you want to be employed again, or?
I mean, I go with DC, but yes, let's all come together as one.
Next question is over here.
What was your favorite part about playing Ollie on Dance Academy?
Dancing, I guess. Like, it was just so cool to be able to dance and act. That was my first full-time acting gig, so I was very, very nervous to be able to transition through a form of art that I already understood was, like, very comforting. I would say that. And he had quite a bit of an attitude. I think I needed to... Sounds weird, but I needed to learn a little bit from him with his, like, cockiness.
Next question over here. Stand up.
What attribute of Wally West would you have if you could have one?
What attribute? Of his personality?
Yes.
Oh, his personality. He's pretty fly. I would say Wally's just fly, you know? And I should say that I am too in my own way, you know? But... yeah, I try to take a little bit of that, a little more. You can always do with more fly. That's why I did it up on the stage.
And the next question is over here.
What was the process that you did to get into the character Wally West? Like, were any comic arcs you read that you felt connected to?
Yeah, I mean, I started with the New 52, and they were just... that was such at the right time for when I was joining, so it was so fresh. And then I had obviously watched religiously the first season, and then I just went right in. I also had watched Young Justice, and that was sad. And then I just went in with my own take too, to sort of like dive into the scripts and let the character become his own thing throughout. So it took a little bit here, a little bit there.
Do you feel any pressure to kind of anchor that character in a, you know, particular style from a particular arc, from a particular comic? Does that ever bother you at all, or you're just happy to make him his own, really?
Yeah, happy to make him his own. I mean, it's ultimately going to be, like bits and pieces and inspiration from all of it, really. When there's so many versions of a character, I think you can't help but include and incorporate parts of them in different ways. And sometimes they don't come out until later. You know, the Wally West arc on the TV show was specific. So we honored that. You can't just try to lock onto something if that isn't in the script. Yeah. So I just sort of flowed with it, and it just kept evolving, really. Yeah.
Next question is over here.
Of all of the episodes of Flash that you appeared in, which one is your favorite?
It would be Flashpoint. Yeah, Flashpoint for sure. Yes.
That's definitive. Next question is over here.
Hi, I have a question on behalf of one of our attendees. Sorry if you've answered this before, but what was your biggest oh shoot moment when meeting a character, not the actor behind them?
When meeting the character and not the actor?
Yeah, so as a fan of the heroes, I'd be more starstruck meeting a character than the actor behind it. Has that ever happened to you?
Oh, you mean like on The Flash?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I was just really... like, I really did look at each of them as their characters in the beginning, because that's all I had taken in. My final audition was with Candace, who to me at the time was just Iris, you know what I mean? So, and then she's in there just killing it. She's crying in the scene, and I'm like trying to keep up, and I'm like, it's Iris, you know? And it was the most surreal thing to me. I was like, yeah, the whole thing was a trip, really. I struggled for a few episodes to to find my grounding and to not be a fanboy. But I'm naturally, that's just naturally in my nature when I really like something. But it took, I got there eventually.
Take yourself off set and go, just be cool, just be cool.
Yeah, be in the trailer and like, Kenan, it's all good. They're not really those characters. They're just people. You're cool. You're just as cool as them. Like, it's, it took me a minute. Yeah.
And next question's over here.
If you were to play another superhero, who would it be?
If I wasn't...
If you were to play another superhero, who would it be and why?
Perhaps Aqualad. I'm not a strong swimmer. Perhaps that would help.
The training for it?
Yeah. I'd be scared of the training. But yeah. That would be awesome to have like the best trainers in the world. And really, I would take it on so that I could become like an average swimmer. That would be lovely.
Are you an average runner?
No, I'm a good runner. Yeah. I'm Kid Flash.
Fair enough. Next question.
Hi, I was just wondering, what's your favorite memory from being on set with Dance Academy?
I suppose like when we would finish the seasons, that's when like, you know, there's a schedule and you're supposed to behave. We were so young and we just had a lot of fun. So I think at the end of season two, we just went and we raided like the wardrobe. Just everyone put on whatever we could find, as many accessories, and we just filmed a music video together, just going through the entire set and bombarded everyone from the producers to the directors, all in the offices and each trailer, and just filmed them and the reactions. Most people were just like this, because we would be there dancing for about 5 minutes, then we'd disappear to the next place.
Did that video end up anywhere?
Yeah, I edited it together, and it's not online, but I think we played it at like the Christmas parties.
Fantastic.
I used to like making like the Christmas party videos, but they're a lot of work. Yeah.
Next question is over here.
Do you find it difficult to get into the headspace of characters younger or older than your actual age?
Yes, for different reasons. I mean, it depends. Like, I don't believe I've booked a job with a character older than me, and I tend to play younger. I've just gotten to a point, I think, where like I just played a 17-year-old again, and I was like, okay, I don't know if I can do that again. I'm 10 years older and I feel a little out of touch with those experiences, just because like life changes so quick. And I felt out of touch. I don't know, if I'm not understanding certain like phone apps and technology, then and I'm not that old, so I don't know what's up. But anyway, so but the beauty of being able to go back younger is like you've gone through those experiences, you have a better perspective on how you were feeling at the time, and you can almost play them better because you have a more well-rounded understanding of those emotions and you can step back into them. So I would think that that's easier. Playing older would be fun. I just have to use more of my imagination and just really like listen to a lot of other people.
Our next question's up here.
Hey, how you doing? I just wanted to start by saying that your voice in the queer community is such an honest and beautiful one. So I just wanted to thank you for that.
Thank you.
And you've been creating some amazing looks, from like your Met Gala look to a lot of the photography work that you've been doing. And I wondered if there's any creatives or designers or anyone that you really specifically want to work with.
Yeah, there's a lot. Mostly I get very inspired from what I see on social media. I kind of did like a bit of a, I had to sort of start fresh, and the way that I use the platforms now is literally just to look for inspiration from all kinds. But even like last week, we're at the Brisbane convention, and just seeing like the creativity that you guys have with the cosplaying and the art that goes on, that sparks ideas too. I get inspired by like video games I used to play, or you know, certain anime, and then just seeing any artist that's out there really expressing themselves, especially in the queer space, because that's where I'm at. And it just, anyone who makes me excited and makes me feel like I watch them, and I didn't know that you could be so, I didn't know you could bring maybe this thing and that thing together, and suddenly someone does it with such ease, and I go, oh cool, what if you put that and that together? Yeah, so it's just, it's a mix. And then I have a really great team. I have a great team of people that, you know, for that Met Gala look, they showed me the dress, and then I worked with my groomer, who was like, you know, we could do these wigs or this, we could go with this look. So you just sort of bounce off of creative energy.
And next question's up here.
Hi. I forgot my question. What was your favorite part of working on the set of Legends, and who's your favorite character?
We always want to know favorites.
Memorable.
Yeah. What was my favorite part about the set? I guess the Wave Rider was cool. I mean, we were there all the time, so it's lucky that I liked it. But it was cool. I guess just the camaraderie. It's such fun episodes and such wacky scripts that you can't really help but have fun. And everyone was just really cool to work with. The characters are super quirky, and depending on, I think they bounce around a lot, so I would sort of get to work with everyone, and it would always be fun and unique, so I can't pick a favorite. No.
Next question is over here.
Have you or anyone you know been hurt on set?
Been hurt on set? Yeah, I mean, injuries definitely happen. I think I've been okay. I think I've been good. But yeah, injuries can definitely happen. I would say if anything, it's more so when I've done like dance jobs. That's when a lot happens, because you're pushing yourself physically every day with dance work. And if you don't stretch enough, sometimes I get a bit eager and I try to do the same tricks that I used to be able to do like every day, and then I can't walk for a week, and yeah, but no major injuries. I'm very blessed.
Our next question's just here.
Hi. I was just wondering if you're going to be touring with your music.
Yeah, I would love to. I definitely will. But as I was saying, like, it's just taking me a minute to figure out what that looks like. And I, in my head, it always looks, you know, it's like on some Beyonce level, like the biggest. And so I'm learning to like bring it down a bit. that actually is quite difficult for me. So I'm just sort of recentering and figuring out really what my taste is for live performance. And then once I get it, like, I'll be there, and I hope you're there too.
So trying to hold back from planning a big Coachella set and just starting small.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Because I was there, you know, I watched that Coachella.
Were you there?
Oh, yeah, of course I was there. Watch. I was bouncing up and down. I was like, oh, my gosh. Yeah, and of course, just having dreams of, like, of that experience. But also, I'm really excited to figure out how to create something special in a minimal space. And if that's all I get to do, I mean, that'd be dope too, so we'll see.
That's exciting too.
Yeah.
Next question just there.
Hi, I was wondering what your best experience being a part of Love, Simon has been?
The best? I mean, all the lives that it affected. I think there's really nothing can beat that, to be part of something that continues to affect people's like personal journeys, their journeys with their family, with their friends. It changes people's perception, queer or not. And that is just like, that's how we move forward in the world. It's so necessary. And the cool thing is that that film was just full of such love and positive energy. And it carried that out. So, yeah.
Next question up here.
Hello, Keenan. I love your work. As an Australian actor who went overseas to the States and stuff, would there be like a piece of advice you might give to an actor in training in Australia wanting to go over to the States or Canada?
I mean, if that's in you and you feel super drawn to go over there and to work, you know, a lot of people love to stay here and build that groundwork and that momentum. And so it's just whichever path feels right for you. If you are wanting to go over there, I would just say, I mean, I want to give good advice, you know? I mean, it's such a journey, right? Like, I went over there, and like, after the first time, like, 4 weeks in, like, I got dropped by my team. And so that's like a rejection that can make you feel like, oh, I've come all this way, you know, maybe I'm not good enough. You have to continually believe in yourself and just keep hustling. So I went back the next year, and you know, and you keep auditioning, keep going through rejections, and you keep sending in your tapes. Continue to be a student, you know, wherever you are in the world. There's a lot of opportunities over there, you know, in both Canada and America, and, you know, Australians are really welcomed, which is awesome. I would say find a community of people that are just as hungry as you and work with each other, learn from each other, learn with each other, and just go for it. Yeah.
Next question is over there.
Hi. In real life, who's faster, you or the Flash?
I actually don't know. I swear we've raced before, and it sounds silly, but I think it was a tie. And all I do remember is thinking, I thought I was going to win for sure. Like, I thought I was, because I'm fast. Grant is very fast. So I guess it's fitting.
Next question is over here.
Hi, my question was like, you were a guest judge on RuPaul Drag Race All Star. Who was your favorite person or queen you met on the show?
Who's my favorite on the season?
On the episode that you were a guest judge. Yeah.
No, I can't pick a favorite. Everyone was incredible, like incredible. And I actually cried. Cry a lot. I was crying when I was watching it live, just all the performances, to see so many people and definitely what people have gone through to get there was amazing. The queens were so talented, and the energy in there was I don't know, it's very tangible. So overall, it was just a pretty magical experience. No favorites, no drama, you know?
Next question is over here.
Hi. If you could work with any artist or actor, who would you want to work with? Thank you.
There's a million artists I would want to work with. There really is. And it all changes depending on where I'm at the time. At the moment, the artist I would really like to work with and sit down and like learn everything I could is this young artist named Jacob Collier. right? Yeah, like that would be sick. Everyone wants to work with him. Any artist that is just like, you know, you can get so caught up, especially in the pop space, which is the space that I am trying to carve through, you can get really caught up in so many different things, and just like the artists that remind you that it's about the music, like they bring you back really just to like the music, it's really special. And there's so many brilliant artists out there right now that are doing that. Like, yeah, it's cool.
Too many to choose from.
Yeah, I want to work with them all.
Just down here.
Can we expect to see you back on The Flash or Legend of Tomorrow as a season regular?
As a series regular, I don't know. I that's not in the cards at the moment. I will be back for a little bit. I can say that. As a series regular, I'm not sure, just because I am focusing a lot on music at the moment, and it just takes a lot of time. But you never know. Never say never.
Next question is up here.
Hi, I just wanted to know what your favourite part of being in a Surgeon or a Legion was.
It was so action-packed. It was my first role in America, and the first scene we shot was like myself and Shailene, and I was in my Dauntless uniform, and we're up on the roof, and we shot for 6 days that scene where they kind of raid us. And I was getting shot at, I was shooting, there was glass breaking next to me, and that was my like first couple days on this job. I guess just my favorite part, looking back, was just the whole experience. Because it was a wealth of experience jam-packed in one job. I was so blown away that I was given that opportunity. And that was from a self-tape from Australia, so it was pretty, the whole thing was pretty cool. And the cast was like such a high caliber of you know, older and younger actors, so it's pretty lucky.
Next question is over here.
So on the set of The Flash, was there any pranks? And if so, what one do you mainly remember, and who was it on?
I don't remember. I really don't. There was a lot of jokes, a lot of laughter, a lot of dancing. And Tom, I would say Tom probably made the most jokes. And if anyone did pranks, I guess it would be him. Yeah, I can't remember.
Next question is over here.
Hi, what is your favorite season of The Flash?
My favorite scene?
I said before, what is your favorite season of The Flash?
I think season 3. That was probably the meatiest for like my character in terms of working on it, but my favorite season was season 1, just watching it, because it was still a mystery to me. It wasn't a mystery once I was like in it.
Does it take some of the magic away to see how it happens?
It's just swapping one bit of magic for another, you know? That's how I would describe it. And once you learn to let go of the mystery and you get to go into a whole different side of it, a really unique experience, especially for someone that's a fan. Yeah, it's cool.
You kind of get used to having everything spoiled.
Yeah. But actually, you know, waiting for the scripts to arrive is just like getting a new it's getting a new episode. You're not watching it, but just reading it, it's just a whole, it's really, really awesome. So we would always look forward to it and see like what you're getting to play out, you know, over the next couple of weeks.
Nice. Next question here.
Hi, my name's Jade.
Hi.
So my question was, if you could branch into any kind of genre of acting, like something you haven't done before, what would you go into?
I've only thought of this recently because I hadn't, I would say comedy, and I wouldn't normally say that. But I got to play a comedic role recently, and that's not where the core of it was, but sort of took it there, and it was just so fun, and I think I haven't really like tapped into that part of me probably since I was like in high school, as I started taking everything so seriously. So I think I'd love to step more into that world.
We've got time for two more questions, so second last one.
Hi. As a musician and with Grant Gustin being a fantastic singer as well and dancer, was there much performing on stage on set between the two of you? And if so, or if not, would you what would you like to do with him if you had a chance?
No, there wasn't much. I mean, surprisingly, almost everyone in the cast has a singing and dancing background. Almost everyone. Danielle always asked me to teach her dancing. So Grant and I haven't sung together, but I think it would be pretty cool if we got the chance to do that. And you know, because Jesse sings, Carlos sings, Candace can sing even if she says she can't.
Musical episode then is what you're
saying. Another musical episode. Yeah, but yo, like, they didn't have me in the musical episode singing and dancing, so if they do another one...
I feel like they missed out.
It's because there's such a wealth of talent in that group, you know? yeah, we'll see.
And the last question.
So this is not related to the show, but are you good at any accents? And if you are, could you give us an example?
No. Am I? I can do just general American accent. I've done like a Welsh accent. I hadn't practiced it and it worked. I'm not going to do it again. It was for an audition. It happened to be really good. And I'm going to leave it at that and just be like, yeah, it was unreal. Captured. Didn't get the job, so maybe it wasn't that good. But I'd love to be able to learn South African. I am not there yet.
All right, well, that's all we've got time for, unfortunately. But please join me in thanking Keenan Lonsdale.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
And thank you all for your wonderful questions. Enjoy the rest of the show.